All About Love, Crystal Davis Wells. Happy 2015, everybody. This is the last show for 2014 for Wednesday's
Woman.
And there are no women in the house except for right now. My mama has just walked in.
Oh, she had to get fixed up. Oh,
yeah, you know what it is.
Yeah, she got it on you the day.
Gotta go out the new year and go into the new year looking good. You understand what I'm saying?
Praise the Lord. Let's give her a
hand. Amen. I am not your host, but my name is Jerry Smith. I am her son, her middle child. And we have with us Uncle Isaiah.
Hey, happy new year. Here we go. I didn't know I was supposed to dress up and put on my tuxedo and all that kind of stuff, too, you know.
Hallelujah.
But it's all right. It's all right.
Hallelujah.
We're making it. Last show of the year. This is New Year's Eve.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Already shot my gun.
No.
But. I promised I would never do it again. You know, it was a personal thing. Yeah. It was a personal thing. I'm under, what you call that thing? Not a probation, but I have a restraining order against me. Yeah, it happened.
Lord.
A buddy and I had a problem a few years ago.
Uh-huh.
And I shot at him 3 times. And we're still having the same problem today, confusion. He thought I shot at him because he ran off with my wife.
Uh-oh.
I didn't shoot at him because he ran off with him. I shot at him because she bought a back.
What?
He could have kept her. I was through with it anyway.
It's cheaper to keep her, man. You know
the song. No, sometimes you send them away.
It's cheaper to keep her.
Yeah, it is cheaper to keep her.
You know the song.
Something happened to him. But, you know, I'm trying not to shoot anymore.
Please don't do it.
We
don't need no more
correct.
Thug life situations going on here.
This is true. You never know where the bullet's going to come down.
Tell me about it.
You don't want to shoot anybody. So what are you doing for the new year?
That's a good question. I'm here right now. I'm blessed to be here. I was scheduled to go to church. Sometimes I usually go to church on the, you know, watch a meeting service, but not this year. So I'm going to be out with a couple of buddies of mine trying to go somewhere safe. No clubs. I don't do the clubs.
I usually go to church on the watch meeting service, but you know I'm a senior now. So at a certain time, we fall asleep, so we not watching nothing.
Right.
We sleep and they watching us.
Watching eyelids.
So, you know, I might later on the computer look at it or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to the churches that have a watch meeting tonight.
Shout out.
That's beautiful. Have a wonderful service wherever you may be. You ready back there?
I'm just sitting here enjoying.
You ready, B?
Wait, don't change the mics and cameras. He got all that together.
But you know what it is? I just feel like there's a performance coming.
Well, yeah, I've been trying to set up something. I didn't know what. I have a wonderful musician in the house. And of course, my son is here. He's a wonderful musician as well. But we have Marcus Miller here today. I'm calling the Marcus Miller, the bass player.
I'm getting ready to say, I know Marcus Miller. Wasn't that one with Luther? To play with Lufa and Anita and all that?
No, it's Chris Miller. Chris Miller. The Chris Miller Band.
Okay.
Is that right?
That's right.
The Chris Miller
fine.
Band. You want me to pick this up? Oh, what do you want me to do? Turn it off? Oh, turn it off.
Turn it on.
On?
Is it on? Oh, my goodness. So, happy Kwanzaa. Happy 2015. Somewhere in the country, it's already 2015.
This is true.
And somewhere in the country, it's going to stay 2014 until a few more days.
January 6th, January 7th.
Yeah,
I think so.
So we have a lot going on in our world. But I have also Brother Osar the Great here. So we got a lot of stuff going on, Uncle Isaiah. But what should I do? Should I sing first or what? I don't know what to do. This is.
Well, I feel there's a song going on.
Okay.
I feel there's a song in your heart. So let's
thank
have
you,
a little
Lord
bit.
God.
Give me a little bit just for Uncle Isaiah.
Yeah.
And just a tribute to Phyllis Hyman.
Uh-oh. What's one of her songs that I ever sing?
I'm getting ready to tell you, give me a little chorus.
Oh, God, I hope I know
give me a little chorus that you make me feel brand new.
That ain't her.
She did.
Stylistics did it first.
Don't try me with my songs now.
Oh, God, she remade it.
Yes,
but
she did. Yes, she did.
Son, go over there and play something for me.
I don't know who in this.
Let me see. How's it? You make me feel brand new. For God bless me with you. You make me feel brand new. I sing this song for you. Make me feel brand new.
If I had a cup, we'd so be all right.
Is that it? But you know, the one... Wait, Phyllis Hyman. Somewhere in my lifetime.
That's correct.
That's too low, though. Son, take it up a little bit. Another key. Oh, that's terrible. Where is Shanice? I need Shanice Wilson. Shanice Wilson sang this song when she was a little girl at Points at a Park in Hollywood. Blew it out. Now, you talking about passing a cup? They passed a hat and took up some money for that baby at Points at a Park. I think it was 1982. I was there. It was a beautiful thing. Now she's singing all over. You know what I mean? Yes. Has her own reality TV show.
Yes, she does.
So shout out to Shanice Wilson and Flex Alexander.
Remember she used the fried chicken right? She did the commercial with Ella Fitzgerald.
She did a scat. Did she do a scat?
Yes, she did.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, that's so cute. You know everything.
Yeah, because you know I taught Ella how to scat.
Oh, God, you are the teaching man.
She forgot
man.
The words one day, and I just said, Ella, don't worry about the words. Just do shoot a bop, get out fit. That's what it was. I never got paid for it, but it's what it was. Not in the history books. That's what it was.
Chris, come over here and cheer. And Brother Osar, you can sit over on that side, and I think there's a camera over there. Because we're going to have, before I left the studio and got glamorous, thank you very much, they were into this, you know, hot topic and subject about us as a people and how we started off and all this other stuff. I don't even want to go into all that, but these are wonderful men that I have here. And you know, Wednesday's Woman, we always say we don't male bash. We are the women who owns and wears many hats, many wigs, weaves, whatever it takes for us to look the part and get the job done. A Wednesday's Woman, she is the woman that you go to when you don't know what else to do. You call up that woman, that praying woman, the mourning woman, the woman who will speak to you in real life truth and tell you exactly how it is and what it should be. You understand me? That's me. I'm one of those. If all that I haven't gotten to be, I'm going to be in 2015. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, somewhere in my time. It was you and me. That's probably not the words. So long ago. She was still alive, when she was still living, I had wrote a song, and I don't know what key to tell you to put it in, son, but it's my song called I Need. Okay, baby, let me have this moment right here so I can hear it. Traveling down a long, lonely road, there is no sound, no loving friends around. My body is weak, my hands ache to the bone. Surely you hear me and hear me when I groan, for I need, Lord, I need. That was my dedication to Phyllis Hyman, because I was hearing her voice sing this when I was writing and the Spirit was giving it to me. Hear my prayer. Oh Lord, please give ear unto my cry. Wipe away my tear-stained eyes. My love is not my own. I gave it for a song. Sing my whole life through. I thought nothing could go wrong. Now I need. listening and viewing audience here, LaRon, do you have that other microphone out, the speaker open out in the front, baby? I want everybody out in the hallway to hear us. You're not hearing me? Yes, baby, that's what I want. I want everybody outside in the restaurant, Brownstone's Bistro, to hear me, because this is 2014, about to be gone, and I'm singing my song. I need, I need. Y'all listen out there. Where'd my boss go? Did he leave? I love this. Uh-huh. Yeah, that was my tribute. Well, without, minus all the other stuff. But that was my tribute to Miss Phyllis Hyman, the late, great Phyllis Hyman. And if I had to give it up to any of the women that have really laid the path and made the way, it would be Phyllis. And then, of course, Miss Whitney Houston. And, yeah, you know, these were the ladies that were under Clive Davis, and they really ended tragically. So you know where I will not be. Praise the Lord. I'm a Davis, but it ain't by Clive. Praise the Lord. It's by Dee Dee Davis, my daddy. So that's the only Davis I'll be under to do anything for me. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. You know I'm with the Most High. So now, Whitney, what would I sing that you sang? Oh, which one did Whitney do? Uh-oh.
I like I'm Every Woman.
Which one is that?
Like
I'm Every Woman. It's all in me. Anything you want right now, I do it naturally. Oh, oh, oh. We know that was first a Chaka Khan, too. But that one that you were just playing,
Valerie
son.
Simpson.
Oh, Valerie Simpson wrote that?
Yeah, she did. Who you think's on those keyboards? That's Astrid and Simpson.
Oh, my goodness.
That's,
see,
oh, man.
Teach.
That's school.
I want to say this, that this year I have already, well, before the year has ended, 2014, I've already started asking for what I want. The book of Matthew 7:7, chapter 7, verse 7 says, ask and you shall receive. Seek and you shall find. Knock and it shall be open. Is it, and the door shall be open, or knock and it shall be open unto you? And if you ask, you know, and you don't ask in the righteous state of mind, if you ask and ask amiss, that means you didn't really have in mind the right thing in heart to do with that what you asked for, so you didn't get it. But I'm asking in full belief and in faith for a band. I need a band to play for me, and that I can produce as well, because I'm a producer. I'm a lady producer. So I I was thinking of a name for my band. Now, you know, I have 5 children, and 3 of them are musicians. And the other 2, they kind of play around with some things, can sing a little bit and all that. So, hey, doctor, you want to come on in? We won't put the camera on you. Uh-huh. So, I just wanted to acknowledge him because he was in the window. Yes. So, the thing is, get in here. So the thing is, you know, this is the Wednesday's Woman Show, and I am your lady host, Crystal Joyce Davis Wells, and you know, it's always an impromptu thing with me. It's a good thing, too. Come on in here, Brother Vince. So the thing is, Happy New Year, Happy Kwanzaa and all that. Yes, Happy Kwanzaa. Kwanzaa has a couple more days left, and it ends on January 1st. But I wanted to say this. I ask, because Brother Daniel gave me a book, a journal, and he said, you know, I felt led to give you this, so I'm supposed to start writing, because the Bible also says write the vision and make it plain, so they that read it may run with it. Your vision can be known and it can be acted out. So I am asking for a band of crystals. What? That's what I came up with, a band of crystals. So it's a band that belongs to me. It's Crystal's band, but it's Crystal's children. But it's also a band of crystals, meaning the brilliantly pure quartz crystal that is found. Where do you find it? In the ground somewhere? Where is it at?
On the ground.
And I told you guys the story about the lady who gave me a crystal. Right. She gave me 3 of them. And I have 2, and 1 is here in the office. So that also helped with that happened after I had spoke, you know, in the spirit that I had requested a band called A Band of Crystals. So I feel that that has already been ordained, and we shall be seeing that band come to life, come to pass, come to happen in 2015. And the other thing is a big house. Now, that's been my desire for God 30, 40 years. But at this time, I've had a big house. It was in Compton. We don't have it anymore, but it's okay. I'm ready for a bigger one. So I found one on Victoria. It's for lease, and it's about $6,000 to round it off, or, you know, between $5,000 and $6,000 a month that they want for the lease. But it's a huge house. Guess what I want to do with it? I want to house musicians, artists, those that can work together and collectively work on projects. We'll create a reality show, and we'll create millions of dollars from projects that we are collectively working on. There's a business project in there. There's music studio. There's film studio. Everything we need to produce and work, I want it in that house. So any of you listening, watching, if you have any idea how you can help me get that house, please give me a call. 323-239-9439. Now, we do have Chris Miller here. Chris Miller has a band. Chris Miller has CDs. Chris Miller has been performing all around this city and probably around the country. And we just recently saw each other. He was on the Prez Blackman show, the Prez Graham. And so he was also at KTYM over there on the Prez show. I was there this past Sunday. And I want to thank you, Prez, for always giving me the respect that you do and giving me the opportunities to present what I do here at RMCGospel.com, which is our gospel station. And I want everybody in here to really continue to do what you were doing when I walked in. You brothers were in such a good conversation. Now, Brother Osar, tell me, you know, right now, how could people that are not only in this studio, but that is watching and that will be watching after we send it out, you know, because we archive on YouTube, how can they hook up with you? And just give them a little synopsis of who you are and what you do and how they can hook up with you.
Well, I am Osar the Great, and I'm a man of many facets. One of my specialties, I guess you would say, is I assist people that have legal issues as it relates to real estate, foreclosure, traffic, parking, child support, you name it. I'm the resident expert in those fields.
How about that?
So if anybody listening has an issue with any of those issues, you can reach me at 323-972-1460.
323-972-1460. 1460. Osar the Great.
Osar the Great.
Okay. Now, what is it that we can do, perhaps something musically, creatively? Can we get together? Is there any programs, projects coming up that we could collaborate on?
You know, I'll say I haven't given any direct thought, Crystal, but possibilities are always unlimited.
Okay.
And so I am a creative person, and one of the things that I see happening is, you know, merging industries. You know, a lot of times people don't think of real estate and entertainment, but those industries are law and entertainment. But those industries can be merged with the right type of creative, you know, energy.
Okay, look, I'm going to ask a question.
Okay, ask a question.
Can you gather some supporters, some financial supporters as well, and create a show on Thursdays called Thursday's Man, who is the provider, the protector, the leader, and his and the strength of his family and community? Thursday's Man, the provider, the protector, the leader, and strength. Do we have any Thursday's Men in the house?
I'm 7 day a week man.
not just Thursday.
See, I got it out. Well, because see, let me say this: because I'm Wednesday's woman, I want to be honored on Wednesdays for who I am and what I do every day of the week. So, since you are a Thursday's man, you are honored for what you do every day of the week for 365 days of the year. So that day is just set aside for you, just like Friday is set aside for the youth. They do whether they cut up or however they do, all day, all night. We want to take time out to honor them for what they do and give them an opportunity to glean some good information and good support from us on Friday. So I'm looking. I haven't really kicked off my Friday's youth program, even though my son has a Friday show here at RNC. He just hasn't really tapped into the, you know, doing it Mother's Family Love Friday's Youth Day. You know, understand? But I'm saying that to you because I know you have a lot of great impact in the community and you're doing a lot of great things. So this show would bring men together. It would bring the men together to honor those that are already doing stuff and help those who are not doing things to start doing things because they'll see you.
I'm with it.
Okay.
We'll have a conversation after
yes.
we come off the air.
Definitely, definitely.
And see how we can structure it and run with it.
Do you play the big drum right there?
I absolutely do not.
Did you hear that? I absolutely do not. Yeah. Okay, I mean, he got the...
You know...
The koofy on, like he could just get out, like he the brothers over there at Leimert Park. Boom.
Chris, I'm musically inclined, Crystal. I love listening to good music. And I even bought me a piano.
Hush up, you bought a piano.
I mean, it's interesting because at the tender age of about 9, I used to take violin lessons, and I was back in Indiana, and the gentleman that trained me, I never forget him. His name was, he was a German. His name was Mr. English. And I used to go on Saturdays, and I don't remember anything about the violin other than how to spell it.
That's a shame. Okay, we'll bring you some that.
I don't know how to play the piano.
We'll bring you some musicianship. Uh-huh.
I bought a piano about 9 months ago, and I was going to commit to 1 hour a day every day. I was going to teach myself how to play the piano. I went on the internet and found some tutorials.
Yeah.
And I just didn't stick with it.
Okay, well, we'll pray for you that you'll get the vision to.
I love you.
You don't need no prayer.
No, he's right. It's just not for everybody.
Well, now, Chris.
You can teach the lesson stuff, but some people
can't really pull it off.
Well, you let them do it.
Now, Chris, what instrument do you play?
I play some percussion.
Well, pull that drum over there.
You know, I'm listening now.
He's listening.
Find that groove, but yeah, I mean,
my son's over there trying to pull up the percussion on the keyboard.
I'm checking him out. He got it going on too.
So what's your band?
Talk about your band, Chris.
Well, it's the Chris Miller Band.
I like that name. Except I'm called Marcus, but anyway, Chris.
I did the same thing that you were doing. I needed to have a band to produce some music and to do some live performances. And it took me a while to get that concept together. It really did. I will share this with you. One of the things that I had to really come to grips with is that when you're looking for the best musicians that you can find and you have a band concept, one of the things that you got to realize is that you do not own those musicians. And the thing about the band concept is you have to structure your band so that no matter who's not available, you can still do your thing.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
It took me a minute to learn it, but it... this is L.A., and you find a lot of very talented musicians. I know that...
out of work.
Well, when you say out of work, imagine this. I worked with Herman Jackson recently, and Herman is one of the most talented keyboard players in Los Angeles. And I would like to incorporate him in my band, and when I have engagements and stuff, I'll call him, but... He's musical director for Peabo Bryson.
What?
They did 11 shows of the Colors of Christmas in 11 different cities now.
Oh, you beautiful, see beautiful.
Flack.
Yeah. Okay. Now the interesting thing is you will not have access to like the best and most talented musicians every time you're out. So what you have to really do is figure out how to make your package work by plugging in somebody different. And it is an art. It really is. It took me a long time to figure that out.
Feel the fire.
Oh, yeah.
Don't do that over here. That's old days.
Yeah. Woo.
That's old days. One short story about that. I'm glad I'm from the age I'm from and where I came from. I got to see a lot of these artists who could really have talent up front down at the Troubadour in the Roxy. One night, that's where I first saw Phyllis Hyman on the same bill with Peabo. Phyllis came out first, all 6'3". Phyllis came out with this big hat, and I mean singing her heart out. Peabo came out. We didn't know he was only 5'2".
Stop it. Was it like that?
Oh, his forehead's the biggest thing on him. He came out in his little white suit, and we're going... Now, is this the real Peabo Bryson? Till he
started singing it.
Till he
open
started
up that mouth.
Because he's right here.
So he was 5'2", and she was like 6'2".
Oh, yeah. And then that's he came funny. Out, they did something together. But, I mean, that's pure. That's pure.
That was a
so
good show,
so you instrumental
sure.
band or?
Yeah. Well, we're instrumental band. I have a couple of vocalists that work with it. I didn't know you sang like that.
I was going to say, do you sing? Because when I put the CD on, I was hearing the instrumental part, and I heard your son singing, falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus. But he did a little reggae beat to it, didn't he? Falling in love with Jesus was the best thing I've ever done.
Sing it.
You have any shows?
That's my baby girl out there.
Anybody too?
You know what? I get shows and they come. Some come well in advance. Few
protection.
They come
in notice,
but come here. I'm going to be at the new.
Never
did. Oh, Watts Jazz Festival.
Oh, okay.
And it's coming. It's coming. We have a new owner of that particular event.
Bless the Lord on my soul.
I'm gonna open it.
No, that's
what month is that?
Hallelujah.
The latest September.
Ooh, okay.
This is the one that was in front of the Dunbar, the old Dunbar.
You know what?
Central.
I thought they were doing it.
Uh-oh, JJ, that's your neck of the woods.
What do you know about that?
Oh, yeah. My baby was, well, he wasn't, but his brother and daddy was born over there. 43rd, right off of Central. 1139 East 43rd Street. Yep.
All right.
Well, they wasn't born in the house, but they lived. Was your grandmama born in the house? I don't know. But yeah, they lived over there for 100 years. Literally, because I think she grew up in the house. His grandmother grew up in the house. And so, yeah, I think there was like a 100-year generation thing there.
There was I kept thinking the name of it, a wonderful book on Central Avenue I picked up. With all the entertainers and the artists over there and everything that was going on back there in the day in the Dunbar Hotel.
Yeah. Some great stuff over there. So let's say me and you get together and do some stuff, Chris Miller. Now, that's my son. He's the middle child.
Mm-hmm.
And he plays keys. He plays drums.
I hear.
So we can get your son on the guitar. That's my baby girl. She sings. She's shaking her head. No, but she sings.
Yeah.
That's Sharice. Uh-huh. So she sings. Come on, baby. Come sing for me. Come sing something, baby. Come on, sugar. Okay. So, Vince, you want to say something while we're here? He said, Happy New Year. Good to see you. He has Conquering Prison Ministries.
All right.
A proposal to Hollywood. A book proposal to Hollywood. Okay. So he's got a lot going on. A book proposal. He's got the book written. And he's also preparing to do some other great things. So we want to definitely pray for our brother, keep him lifted up, and support him when we hear what is going on. Okay. So, yes.
No, you have, I didn't realize you were such a talented vocalist. Oh. I heard you play a little piano early, but I heard you
met
say,
me.
Yeah.
Yeah. Said, he's known me since I was 15.
15 years old.
But you know, in addition to your extraordinary vocal skills, you have an advantage. You actually have a platform to promote where you're going to be and what you're going to be doing.
So where am I going to be? Right here at RMC. Son, what can we sing for the people? What are you doing, honey? I don't know that one. Okay, now, let me see.
You want to sing Chorus of my new favorite song?
What is it?
Well, you know I don't like too much contemporary music.
Oh, Lord, it's the old one.
But I woke up one day, and the television was on.
Had some good day.
Age, the television never goes off.
That's right, that's right.
I heard this tune, and I looked and I said, wait a minute, what is this boy talking about?
What?
His name is Bruno Mars.
Uh-oh. I heard him.
And it's a group. I don't know what the Uptown Funk means. I don't know what
Uptown
that means.
Uptown Funk.
But he got him a new little tune, and the hook is, don't believe me, just watch. He's got the horns going
don't
on.
Don't believe me, just watch.
Kind of soul.
Don't believe me, just watch.
So that'll be your theme for 2015.
Don't believe me, just watch.
That's right.
It's all right. But you know what I want to say? You got to help me find that song then so I can hear that. Because I heard he was one of the Jackson's sons or something. Jermaine, Tito, somebody's son.
Well,
but then
you know,
somebody
they
said
have
no.
A lot of babies, but he's a talented.
From Hawaii, he ain't no Jackson.
Yeah, he has music, real music again.
What was the song? Oh, what was the song I was just doing? I've had some good days. I've had some hills to climb.
Daddy took us to church. That's the organ.
Days. Some sleepless nights. That might be too hot.
More than this.
tears away. Turn my midnight into day. So I've learned to say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
You know, we've been lied on. We've been talked about.
Well,
we've been mistreated.
Yeah.
We've been kicked and tossed around.
Come on, sister.
But I guess what?
Hey.
Tell you what.
What?
I won't complain.
That's right.
Because I know God has got more for me in store than is good, than your bad could ever mount up to. So, matter of fact, I rebuke you and your bad. And I cancel your bad assignments, and I send it all back to the pit of hell in the name of the Lord God that I knew back in the day, and they still claiming him today as Jesus the Christ of Nazareth, Yeshua, in the Hebrew, you understand me? We put it in that name, put it under that name, and we shut it all down. That's what I need you people to start doing. I need you people to start praying. Speaking the word of the Most High God. Speak the power of the truth. See, if you know the truth, speak the truth. If you know how to act right. So, now you know I can get on my soapbox and start preaching and teaching. But the real deal is it works. You understand? Now, I know Osar the Great. He has learned some things. He studied some things. He can probably come and tell some other stuff. I can't deny what has already been written and done. You understand? Things have been hidden from us because they don't want us to know. And if you know what I'm talking about, you'll understand. But when you know who you are, not just your heritage, not just your legacy, but when you know who you are on a spiritual level. See, some folk claim that they are a God because the Bible said they are gods and lords many. You know, there's the little G God and the little L Lord. You understand? Sarah called her husband Lord. So we can't get it all tripped up. Well, what? The Spirit of the Lord is in you? You made in the image? I'm not going to say nothing about that. I'm just going to say I am who I am. Praise the Lord. And I'm glad to be who I am. I ain't trying to be like you. Now I got my wig on. That's all right. I can take it off and I'll have my natural in a minute because that's what I had on before I stepped into this. You understand me? I saw the Black Riders down there at Ramona's burrito place. You know, you got the brown and the copper mixing together. Because, see, we came up together. I'm talking about our Hispanic, is that what you want to call it, Latino brothers and sisters. We all came up together.
The copper was, okay.
Yeah, we the copper tone people. I realize I'm not black. I'm copper tone because the true original dictionary meaning of American was the copper tone people that was here when the Caucasians came. Hallelujah.
Okay.
Hallelujah. Can I get a witness for the truth? It's about time for the truth to come out.
Well,
you can't hold on.
Come on
any longer to a lie. You gotta let it go.
Well,
turn it loose.
Yeah.
Let it go.
Yeah.
And the truth. Yeah. You don't want to hear that. But it's all right. Turn off the computer if you want to. But I'm going to keep on everywhere I can get a chance.
Oh! Right.
I ain't had nothing to drink but water. Praise the Lord. I ain't had nothing to smoke because I don't smoke no more. Hey, things I used to do, I don't do no more. Things I used to do, things I used to do, I don't do no more. I don't do no more. But how about you? Hey, places I used to go, I don't go no more.
Where?
Places I used to go, I don't go no more. Places I used to go, I don't go no more. I don't go no more. But how about you? I don't know what you come to do. I don't know what you come to do.
I don't know what you come to do.
I don't know what's on your mind.
Well,
but the word of God is right on time. I come to lift God up, lift the praises up.
Him up.
I come to sing my song, let you know who I am.
Well,
I come to entertain my guests,
yeah.
Come to give God praise.
Well,
come to have a good time and ring in the new year. Hey, I don't know what
you come to do.
I don't know what you come to do.
You and you.
You and you and you and you.
I don't know what's on your mind. But I know the truth is right on time.
Hey! Da 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 da.
Yeah. See what they say. These songs is down in our soul. And just like the song we used to sing, just like fire.
Shut up in my bones.
Just like fire.
Shut up in my bones.
Just like fire.
Shut up in my bones.
Just like Holy Ghost fire.
Shut up in my bones. Shut up in my bones.
Fire.
Shut up in my bones.
See, this is how we used to sing and praise, and we still do. I was doing it last Sunday. I went to the church with my son. We're on 104th and Weston. Y'all want to go to church? My son will be on the organ, 10405 Southwestern Avenue, Pool of Bethesda. They be getting down. Mm-hmm. Have you tried my Savior?
Right.
Have you tried my Savior?
Right.
Have you tried my healer? Deliverer.
He's alright.
I tell you that he's alright now.
He's alright.
I tell you that he's alright right now.
He's alright.
The whole head, the whole head is alright. And the body too. Cause if the head's alright, the body is alright. Head's alright, the body is alright. Head's alright, the body is alright. Don't believe the lies. Don't believe the hype. Don't believe the devils and the demons. You know, just turn that TV off and you'll be alright. That's me, baby. That's me talking. But it's real talk. Cause y'all got to know something. We've been hoodwinked and bamboozled, baby, by the television things, okay? All them TV shows y'all be watching, you need to shut them down. If you're not creating your own, you need to shut it down and stop listening and stop watching. Because it's got you acting like somebody that God did not create you to be. Now, I'm telling you what I know. I don't like watching TV because you get all into it and it gets all into you.
Right.
So what do you want on your mind? Something that's going to not just make you rich, but make you really wealthy from the spiritual, mental, and the physical. That's what you need to be watching. And I guarantee you some of them shows you've been watching is not making you healthy, wealthy, or mentally, you know, astute. So get a grip on yourselves. Come back to where you know your grandmother and your great-grandmother was. I'll tell you where they was. Ha. They was ironing. They was cooking. They was cleaning. They was watching your mama and your daddy and your grandparents. They were watching and making sure they did the right things. They were teaching them. They were talking to them at the dinner table and telling them how to act. You know, like Uncle Isaiah said, don't you be going out the house looking like that. You can't be wearing that out the house. See, this is what we got to go back to. The song said, let us all go back. Back to the old landmark. Uh-huh. Now let us all go back to the old time way. Let us all go back to the old time way. Ha! Where the mother, father, sister, brother, children were all together. Auntie, uncle, grandmama, and grandpapa was doing the things they supposed to do, going to church, going to school, making a living. Making a way for you to be who you are today, but what did you do? You say, oops, bumbled up, oops, upside the head, all that kind of foolishness. We had all this kind of stuff going on back in the day. I'm from 1960. I was born July 18, 1960. I ain't ashamed to tell it. So what went on from the 60s, 70s, 80s, and the 90s up to the 2000s that we are now? It's a shame and a disgrace for y'all to be carrying on like that. Now, I don't know who's watching. I don't know who's going to be listening to this. But understand, Mama Christo is talking right now. See, this is part of the Wednesday's Woman. You got to be able to be the mama sometime. You got to be able to be the girlfriend sometime. You got to be able to be the sister sometime, the mother. But you got to be able to be all things to all people at the time and the time you need it. You understand me? Tell it like it is. Is that all right, Uncle?
You said it.
Praise the Lord.
You took us to a revival. You brought your soul soon. You brought them up. One thing about the music.
Yes, yes.
About the music. They're so reveling about that. That's called getting a song on the wire. It's a song on the wire. Yeah, yeah. You come to church, you get a song on the wire. See, old school, new school don't know how to do that anymore. Old school, you had a testimony. Right, a testimony. Ooh, you had to have testimony. A song.
Come out here, song. You had on a the song. Wire.
You woke up. I said, I woke up this morning.
Yeah.
Hey, hey. And when I woke up, it was a beautiful day.
Yes, Lord.
I went to have some pancakes.
Uh-oh.
But didn't have no syrup.
Uh-oh.
And I thought, how can I have pancakes? Don't have no syrup.
Uh-oh.
But then I had a beach. I looked up and I saw a bag of sugar, and I saw some hot water.
Hey,
I saw sugar, and hot water. I put them together. I had some sugar syrup.
Hush your mouth.
So I had my pancakes this morning. Woke up this morning with my mind stayed on pancakes, and I had it this morning. And see, you do that. That's how it rolls. That's how it rolls.
It's on the wire.
Yeah, that's all. Everybody got right on the wire, no matter what, running from the devil or whatever. But that was a Pentecostal tradition.
We had that. Yes, we did.
But you kept that tradition.
Yes.
See, the other part, the Baptists, the Methodists, a lot of them try to take that out.
Oh.
And they try to be more European in their expression in their church. But Pentecostal kept the drums and the music and all
yes,
that.
Yes, we do have
That's
that.
Where Mahalia Jackson
Mahalia.
Was born. She went to the Baptist church where they were proper. But she snuck across the Pentecostal church and got the drums and that beat. And that's where that came from.
Go. So that's how that happened?
That's how that happened. She didn't want to be Bessie Smith, but she went over there and took that.
Wow.
You should say that because even, you know, with my quote-unquote religious viewpoints today, I actually lived in a building or a house, because we had big Victorian-style houses back in Indiana. And I lived with my oldest brother, my father, in the house that was the headquarters for the PAW. I don't know if anybody knows.
Oh, yeah.
Assemblies of the world.
My pastor was the head of that portion of the PAW in the Midwest region. His name was Bishop M.E. Golder, Morris E. Golder. Mm-hmm. So I was raised up in Grace Apostolic Church on 21st and Broadway in Indianapolis, Indiana. And so
look at that.
In the day, back in the 60s, Bishop R.W. McMurray used to come and do tent revivals. So what the brother's saying about, they call it praise and worship today, but we didn't call
it.
It was testimony service.
Everybody
stood up and they, you know, you got your opportunity to testify. They would sing a song. And that's
you better go ahead.
And it was
we got a witness in the house.
I mean, back in the day when I was growing up and went to church.
Glory.
Like, if you didn't go to church, you know, my perception was, what's wrong with you?
Mm-hmm.
I went to church as much as I went to public school.
Woo, wow, that's pretty serious.
Went to church.
You was in church, bro.
All week long.
You was in church.
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah, I mean, Sunday school on Sundays. You know, I would go to my brother. I'd go to my class for Sunday school. My brother would go to the junior class. The adult class.
This
was for years.
That's awesome.
That's Sunday afternoons.
Osar the Great.
Mm-hmm.
See, he is proclaiming his greatness. This is what the rappers are doing, the people in the industry, because they got money, they got fame, they got notoriety. So they, I'm this, that, and the other. But this brother ain't no rapper.
Nope.
I don't know.
But I rap.
How much cash money you got in the bank and in your pocket. But he is claiming his greatness because of what he knows about himself and what he's been taught about the whole nation of things. He's got some real good knowledge. I want y'all to know. Yes, son. You ready to leave, Sugar? Well, we've showed and enjoyed. You got another song for us. He was over there on the keys. So now.
Great musician.
Yeah, thank you. Like I said, 104th and Western.
Great musician.
Going over there and help out Elder Pastor Burl Love. They need a little help over there. I was with him Sunday. Yeah, well, see, you got to get turned up when I come in there, because I come in turned up. I had my shades on. I came in the door looking.
Turned up.
All right, what's going on up in there? And they know me. they know already. They grew up with me.
Crystal.
Baby, look at here.
Turn.
I can't sit down. I don't think I ever sit down. Did I ever sit down? I think I did sit down at one point when the man was preaching. Right. He didn't preach that long.
So do you remember that old song,
You gone, baby? We'll see you later. What
remember
song, baby?
Song called Sit Down, Servant? I Can't Sit Down? You ever heard that song?
No, how'd it
go? I'm serving, I can't sit out. It says, I just got to heaven and I can't sit out.
Sit down, servant.
I can't sit out.
I think I heard that.
Servant, okay. I can't sit out. I can't sit down.
Happy 2015, baby.
Yeah. When you said that, that made me
so
think like that.
This is who we are. We are live wires.
We are live
wires. We stay on the wire. Mm-hmm. That's how come we are so creative. God made us this way. He made us truly in his image. We are quick. We are powerful. Because that's how our God is. What does that mean? If you're the first, guess what? You're going to be the last. And guess what? The last is back in front.
Come on now. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. He's gone now, and I don't know how to play that music. I don't know how to get that one.
That's the truth. I had to shout on that myself. See, that's what's up. We're back on the top. Things are being transferred over. It's being changed over.
Oh, yeah.
Y'all watch.
The state is changing hands.
It's got to.
That's true.
I thank God for you, President Barack Hussein Obama, because no matter what they say, you do represent a race of people that is of us. So it makes us really look good if we act right. When we act right, it really works well. But I want you to know, your support is yet still to come. This is just me talking. But it's really yet to come because the folk gonna get it together. They gonna stop laying in the street, burning up their own McDonald's. What did they say? They burn up their own McDonald's, burn up where they live. Mm-hmm. They're gonna stop that because some knowledge and the wisdom of man is gonna be set aside and the wisdom of God is going to be implanted. It's gonna come up out of them. So people like me and people like those that are in here, we're gonna continue to speak the truth. We're gonna continue to sing. We're gonna continue to pray and press forward. Because y'all gon' get the message. Because it said many are called, but few are chosen. I believe we are the chosen few up in here. Mm-hmm. We're of the chosen few. Now, I don't ride a Harley, but I'm still a chosen few. Come on, Pastor Warren Smith. Where you at? He's a Holy Ghost rider.
Well, you're too tall for the bike.
Special order.
That's right. I get a special order.
She thought she'd be looking like Fred Flintstone. Well, with the feet.
You're a mess. So the thing is, what I'm saying, y'all get ready because there's a move of the Spirit of the Most High God that is yet to be seen. Because, see, it has no color, but you're going to feel it and you're going to see the results. Okay? This is what I say. A move of God has no color. Hey, Mr. Wells. Come on in here, brother. He's standing there, too.
I'm going to give you a quick testimony.
Go on, give us a quick testimony.
Last night, I'm leaving Ralph's supermarket. Uh-huh. Coming down Wilshire. I know I need to talk
to the National Housing Service because of a situation I'm going through, and I'm also trying to take 4th District candidacy for 4th District Councilman. So anyway, so I'm coming down Wilshire. On my way to 7-Eleven at Wilton, I remember I need to talk to this establishment. I said, let me find the exact address. So I turned my bike around. I come back up Wilshire. I said, there it is right there. I see it. It's a gate. It's an electric gate. Now it's 8:30, 9 p.m. The electric gate swings open, right? I kid you not. And because I've manifested John 14 in my life, right? So I already know I'm walking with him, right? So the gate swings open. I said, okay, Dad. I said, so I know this. Okay, so I know you want me to go here. I guess you want me to go in here and check out the establishment, right? I said, but don't lock me up in here, right? But I'm going up in here and check this out. But don't lock. But I see it's a door next to it, too. So I'm assuming I can come out from the door, right? I just get in and come out. So I ride my bike on in, go on, check it all out, look at it. And as I turn around to come back, I see the gate closed. Oh. Right? I said, I sure hope I'm not locked up in here. Dad, come on, we ain't got no time for all this. Well, because the gate, now the gate is open. So now I'm locked in, so I got it on my phone. So I have to lock my bike. Uh-oh. I got groceries. I got to climb the gate, leave the groceries, pull them through the fence, right? I go to 7-Eleven, tell the little guy at 7-Eleven the testimony, show him the telephone. My bike is still locked over there. So I'm thinking he wants me to be here first thing in the morning. This is his way of telling me, I need you here first thing in the morning. Walk to the house. I'm going to spend the night, right? This is where I need you because I'm going through this trial right now, right? I'm in fire. I'm in test, right? So I leave the bike. I go there this morning, but the place is closed. So what he's telling me, and it even goes deeper because I was entertained with the sheriffs this morning, too. So it's deep, but the God is moving. The doors is open. I was down there passing. I'm coming out of Beverly Hills one night. I'm putting flyers through all these doors. Security is up in one building. I can't get the flyer. The door is just open. So he's here. He's moving. Our angels are down. Mm-hmm. John 14 is moving. He says the word is good today, yesterday,
and forever. Forevermore. John 14. He says it's our season. The door is open. So we ain't even got to knock on some of Psalms 50. I brought my drum over here by me. That's Brother Vince Young. So we know the church is about to get turned up over there, getting ready to have their watch meeting all night long. They're going to pray and sing until after midnight, and then they're going to all jump up and cry and praise the Lord and be happy because they made it through. But I want you to know, baby, it's already over. You understand? We done already missed this whole 2014. It's done. We already in 2015. We probably there about 2 weeks ago because, you know, they keep changing the calendars. Leap year, leap month, take a day, add another. So don't y'all get caught up in all that. That's my thing, too. Stop getting caught up in all this stuff.
Yeah.
Just live every day the best of your ability and be thankful to the Lord our God, because we know these are tricks of the enemy, because the Bible already tells you they'll try to change the seasons and all that kind of stuff. So y'all stay focused on, you know, keep your head to the sky. Look and see what's up there, because I told this lady one time I was walking in the parking lot of Ralph's over here on Pico. And I said, you know, you all need to start looking up, because God wants us to look up, and that gives you such a different feeling. And they both start looking up. And I said, and see, those are two seagulls. They fly real high up there. And I never would have seen them had I not looked up. And I mean, not just look up right there. I had to look all the way up. And people think you're crazy. They do. I don't blame them, because I'd probably think I was crazy, too, if I saw me doing some. And I'll throw my hands up. I don't know if my arms have been shaved too good at. So I don't throw my hands all over. You know, Church God in Christ, PAW, we weren't supposed to have all this on. I know I'm looking like back out and everything. You understand? What you had a camera on my husband for?
I was showing my back out. It's sexy.
Praise the Lord. So, yeah, I know. We'd have been put out of the church,
You come a long way. Y'all, I don't even know how you guys got babies, because you was some homely looking thing.
Well, see, he ain't right.
Well, let's tell the truth.
He trying to say the folk was so homely, he don't know how they got babies. See,
all the way down and didn't have any makeup on. You come to school crunched over looking like this.
That's a shame.
But baby, when y'all got the chance to put on makeup, some of y'all put on every piece of makeup you can put on your
gold
face.
Gold and blue and silver, all up.
God doesn't like that. That's just religion. That's the laws. That.
So the things that we've learned, we somehow have to unlearn and learn the truth about things. Y'all don't be pointing fingers and judging people. Just recognize the fact that they're walking in freedom. You need to get loose. You need to get free. And allow yourselves to really enjoy the life that God has created. Like I said, look up. Look up. Because your redemption draweth nigh. Mm-hmm. So look up. And I have always admired, the Lord has shown me rainbows. There was no rain, nowhere to be found for days, weeks, months. But there was a little rainbow. And I'd be like, oh, I'd be on the train, not the Metro Rail, the real Amtrak train, traveling through. And it was like I look out the window, Lord, but show me. And I was like, oh, Lord. So all along, I believe God gives us signs that he's with us. We're on the right track. Mm-hmm. You're doing the right thing. Mm-hmm. And rainbows and me have been friends. He shows me colors. What you got to say on that?
I was going to say Stevie Wonder calls them ribbons in the sky.
Oh, is that what he calls
That's
them?
That's what it was, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
There's a ribbon in the sky for our love. Congratulations to you. Oh, we have a phone call. The phone call is lit up. Who's there?
It's lit.
Well, you know I'm from South Central. Baby, answer that phone. Hey, what you mean it's out there? Hello, is anybody there?
Yes, hello, ma. This is Sister Crystal, please.
I can't hear you.
This is Drew Murray, Sister Crystal. How are you? Can you hear me?
Okay, now. Oh, I need a. Oh, wait, hold. Hold on. Oh my goodness. Just stay there right now. Hey, get that ready for me, sweetie.
And while you're putting those headphones on, Crystal, I just wanted to chime in and say about this Keeping It Real thing. Actually, this is the end of a fiscal year. This is not the end of a solar year, because the year doesn't never end in the dead of winter. Right. The year ends and begins around
the
spring.
Get the
banner. So what we're experiencing and what we're going into is the end of a fiscal year.
Okay.
Okay, wait a minute. Now, is there a caller on the phone?
Well, I'm sorry, Sister Crystal. This is Drew Murray.
Hi, Brother Drew!
How are you?
Oh, wonderful and fantastic. How are you?
I'm doing okay. I just got your email a little while ago.
Uh-huh.
Did you want to write down my number?
Well, it's probably going to go live on the show.
Oh, we don't want that.
Yeah, but everybody, this is Pastor Cecil Chip Murray's son. Say hi to Brother Drew Murray.
Hello, Pastor Cecil Chip Murray's son.
Hello.
Then just call me Drew.
He said, just call me Drew.
Just call you Drew. Just call you something. But that's good to be his son, though. Be proud of it.
Okay.
Yeah, it is.
He's a phenomenal person in this, especially in this city.
Definitely.
Yeah. Okay, so why don't you want to put it in the email or just what you want to do? But you know what?
Call you back Friday.
Today is Wednesday. Yeah, I should be here Friday. And you know what? It's probably on the caller ID.
Okay.
So that's what I'm going to do. I'm so glad to hear your call.
I'm glad to hear you call, too.
Yeah. All right. Well, I'm definitely looking forward to getting with you and the whole team. And let's move some things along that we've talked about.
Okay,
sweetie. God bless you.
Happy
New Year.
Happy New Year.
Okay, Brother Wells, Brother Drew said hi.
Hi, Brother Drew.
Looking forward to meeting you, my brother.
Yes, sir. You too.
Oh, this is so awesome. Awesome. I love this. All right, brother. See you. Now,
is he still there?
He's gone.
No. Now, what it is, Brother Vince, you got to go. You want to get the keys? Honey, can you get the keys? Get my keys right over there. It's the pink key ring. I mean, the pink key. And on the side, my keys are over there, I think.
Right here?
Yeah.
These?
So, LaRon, can you put the song on? Which one? Put on Deliverance Will Come, the first one. And then you can keep it open. Uh-huh. Keep that open. Is it on? Bye, sweetie. Peace and blessings.
Happy New Year. Happy New Year.
Yeah, this song is a song that I wrote and produced back in 92. I can't hear it. Should I turn my mic off or something? Can you hear it? Oh, it's in there?
It's in here.
Shucks. Here, hold on to yours. Give me those.
Now, this song is called Living Water. Let me hear it. I don't hear it.
Deliverance.
Oh, that's Deliverance. That's Shay Norman.
Don't
you know him?
Worry.
Shay Norman sings with Fred Hammond.
It won't be this way.
Yeah. Turn it up. Let that roll. I want to hear that. God bless you and listen to that. We'll be back.
Just keep on praying and fasting. Your miracle is on the way. You can bear, and he won't put more on you than So when you feel your faith fading, just keep on praying and believing it's coming. Deliverance will come. Deliverance will come. Praise. Oh, your triumph is in your praise. It's in your praise. God is a God of timing. He may not care where you want him, but he's always on time. Yeah. Without faith, it's impossible He who cometh to God must believe that he is. So when you feel your faith fading, just trust and know.
Isn't that great? That was good. Wow. Well, I have that CD, and I'm very privileged and blessed to have that CD. I've had it for a few years, and the whole thing is just fantabulous. It's off the chain.
As the kids say, they slept on him.
Yeah. He's
that's a serious dude.
You
right
ain't
there.
Heard nothing. There's some stuff on there, man.
He can almost all sing me.
I heard you.
Almost.
And see, that's when I was driving my gold Benz. I used to play that in my gold Benz. I'm getting another one, y'all. Pretty soon. Now listen, I want to say something regarding what we're doing. I just passed out a couple of cards. This is my Family Love Festival card, and this card gives the address: 621 West Rosecrans Avenue, Studio 9, Gardena, California. 90247, and it's something that we're planning to do at the warehouse. It's a Family Love Festival, a festival of talents, gifts, and wares. So if you're a vendor, you have product. If you're an artist, you have things that you've created, paintings like this big mural on the background here, singers, bands. We are opening up for you. It's a theater, small little theater type of a setting that we want to create, and opportunities for people to, like I said, sell their wares, present their gifts and their talents, and get paid. We want to make some money at the same time. So you guys call us at 323 239 9439 for further information on the Family Love Festival. Music revives the people.
That's right.
So we want to start bringing out good music. Mm-hmm. And on that second CD, player number 8, I believe, is a song, My Baby Boy Did That. And I want to also, you know, focus on some of the music that we have done as a family over the years. So we can go ahead on and roll that, and then we'll get ready for another few songs from the other children, okay? All right, so this is called... Uh-oh. Try it again. Try another one. The last one. Yeah, that's it. Turn that up. Let me hear that. As my baby boy is called, it's a party on the weekend, okay? It's a New Year's Eve party jumping off in the middle of the week. But we want to listen to this. This is Christian Ramone Beats made by Fresh.
Star. Ride around town in a fancy car. Bad bros be looking at me from afar. See, they with it. I get them digits to see them tomorrow. If it's a party, then it's going down. Yeah, it's a party when I come around. Fresh, it's who they want and I know it. Yeah, I'm too high. See me smoking above the crowd and I'm floating like I'm gone, gone. Have the party back in my place. Music real loud, make the floor shake. It's okay, it's not an earthquake. It's just a party, this is how we do it all day.
It's a party on a weekend. We gon' party on a weekend. Get retarded on a weekend. Cause it's a party on a weekend. It's a party on a weekend. We gon' party on a weekend. Get retarded on a weekend. Cause it's a party on a weekend.
The lifestyle of Project X is how I'm living. Single life. Party time, no children. Young, wild, and free. Partying to the limit, I'm feeling this Rossi. I'm off of Bacardi. Put up a chair, now these girls are dancing on me. The mindset of a freak, I just wanna see you dance, girl. Dance, girl, show me that you can shake it. Then I'll take you to my world, my world. Party like no tomorrow. This is a celebration, no time for all the sorrow. Just party hard at my place. It's the weekend, we party hard all day.
It's a party on a weekend. We gon' party on a weekend. Get retarded on a weekend. Cause it's a party on a weekend. It's a party on a weekend. We gon' party on a weekend. Get retarded on a weekend. Cause it's a party yeah. on a weekend.
We living every day like it's the weekend.
Yes, it's a party. It's a party on the weekend. We're going to fade that out. Let me hear what number 2 says on that other song around. Let's see if that's one of the songs I'm looking for. Let's see. Let's see. Let me pull up my earphones. Yeah, that's it. So this is my son. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? This is my son, J Beats. I don't know if... Can you hear me, LaRon? Hello? You can hear me? Okay. This is my son, Jay Beats. He was the one that was here earlier on the piano, so that's him. So I'm just going to be doing some previews of my children. Oh, I don't hear it anymore.
Okay, let's hear that. I need a 9 to 9, working like it's hammer time. I stopped skating, but a dude still on the grind. Reason to make maneuvers to get through traffic sooner. Busy delay your stress, cause I don't want it too much. Stress passion with an everlasting passion. Smashing through the city with my seatbelt fastened. Looking both ways as I sprint the intersection. Cops on my head, but they know I got connections. On a money mission, so I add to my collection. Got my own whip, but
but I'm still a pedestrian. I was raised in the streets, seen a lot of people getting paid by the cheek. Bread plus heat, no choice but increase. I take it out the oven, then I put it on repeat.
Yes, that's my middle child. The first one was my baby boy, Christian. And that was Jared. They actually did a collaboration on that. Christian did the music. Jared did the rapping. And then we're going to play this song by Brother Chris Miller's son. What's his name? Nicholas?
Nicholas.
Oh, yeah. Nicholas Miller. So tell us a little about Nicholas.
Well, Nicholas is my youngest son. He's decided that he wants to be a musician. And he's been active in his church for... ever since he was 6 years old, he's been singing.
Okay, and, drop that track on there, number one, and let's see what Nicholas is saying. Six-year-old Nicholas?
No, well, no, he's not.
Oh, he ain't anymore. Six now.
Not six anymore.
Okay.
Oh, boy.
Let's see what we got. Okay, I love it.
Oh, yeah.
Arms never disconnected. In his arms, I feel protected. There is no place I'd rather be. Yeah, yeah, there's no place I'd rather be. Yeah, yeah, there's no place I'd rather be. Falling in love with Jesus, yeah. Oh, oh, I'm falling in love with Jesus. Yeah, yeah, I'm falling in love with Jesus. Yeah, it is the best thing I've ever done. Yeah, yeah, the best thing I've ever done.
Yeah. Like best that. Thing I've ever done. You like that, Uncle Isaiah? We're just
like
playing
that.
Some little bits because we really are over our time, but we're taking this time because we know we can. I don't believe anybody else is coming after us. And nobody really came before us. We had all the places. Everybody was just out celebrating. But what I want to say, too, I think there's another song. Where is your son performing at?
He's performing at Tamarind Avenue Church in Compton on a regular basis.
Okay, Nicholas Miller.
Yeah.
Tamarind Avenue Church in the city of Compton. Any Comptonites watching, go out to Tamarind Avenue Church and look for Nicholas Miller. Now, put that other track on for the other one over there, and let's see what it's saying. You hit the... Okay. Is it... Did you hit play? What's happening? Oh, wait. Let me put the thing on. Oh, no. I want number 9. Was that number 9? Okay, go to 10. That was my children, Kingdom Kids. Okay, now this is also... Turn it up, baby, because this is how what our other young folks do. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And this is my oldest son. It's a little old, but...
Smoke by the pound, drink by the fifth. I pop by the handful, nigga, this is it. I'm feeling myself in my brand new fit. I'm about to go home with a brand
well,
new bitch. I mean,
this is what some of our young people are doing. Can we deny that they're doing it? We cannot deny it. This is what you know. You have to pray and ask God to bring deliverance. Help them. Save them that need to be saved. You understand?
Oh, yeah.
See, that's my son.
Oh, yeah.
I cannot deny that's my son. That's how he felt. That's what he was doing. Yeah, baby, you heard it. I tried to talk over some of it.
You know, I have a similar issue with Nicholas. He produces Rock Band.
Okay.
And they're good. They're really good. But I'm hoping that he gets a bigger boost from gospel music. It's amazing. It's like there are two worlds competing for his interest.
Do you understand? Do you understand?
Yeah.
So, now go to the next song, number 11, and let's see what we got on there. Uh-oh. Now, he's finna go off right here. Now y'all get your ears ready, because he's finna go off. Lord, y'all forgive us, but this is what he did. He was angry. So now what he was saying, he was angry because somebody snitched on him. And he was like, man, I'm gonna give my gun. So these are the realities of some of our children, some of our cousins, some of our grandchildren are dealing with this mentality. It used to make me nervous when I would hear some of his music. Oh my God, what is my son going through? Don't you know I pray constantly? You understand? Yeah, you know too. But I thank the Lord that he's made him who he is. And soon the things are going to be really manifesting that the mothers are praying for. Lord, deliver my son. Bring him up. I want him preaching. I want him teaching the word. I want him singing the gospel. You understand? So you can hear these things now, and maybe like a few more months, a few more years, I don't know how long it'll take for deliverance to come. You know, but we have to know this is what's out there. Okay, baby, that's good. He said he put that on his mama. You understand? He was that serious. I put that on my mama. You understand? But anyway, now those are my three sons. Now you heard all three different types of music, and that was one of your sons.
Yeah.
So this is four men, young men, voicing their music. Now, we had one falling in love with Jesus, but he's also doing Rock Band.
Yeah, yeah.
So, now, husband, I hear you over there. Turn it up, sugar. We ain't shy. Turn it up. Turn it up. Turn it up. Now, your wife is speaking. Please turn it up. Oh, see, now, now, disobedience is what? Is that it?
Yeah, but you giving the order.
I just said turn it up.
Then your wife is speaking.
So turn it up, baby. Turn it up. Sweetie, can you just turn it up for me? Now keep doing what you were doing. I just wanted to hear a little bit. That's underground, behind the scenes music. That's all. Oh, God. Yeah, thank you. Do right.
Well, I'm going to
talk about
take care of my seniors.
Okay, let's give some shout-outs to the seniors. Go ahead.
Take care of the seniors. They had a rough time last night. We had to go to emergency.
Hush your mouth. Who went to emergency?
My 97-year-old aunt. We had to take her emergency last night.
She okay?
Yeah, but she kind of got on my nerves. Because she got the emergency and started sitting there being cute.
What you mean? Instead of telling the doctor what was
hollering
going on?
Hollering and screaming so they can take her to the back room.
Well, that's you know how to act.
Oh, that's how you got to do it.
Get me in there.
Get me out. Okay. Get me to
the back
room.
Do that?
No, she. I said, I thought you were in pain.
Oh, stop.
This is not a party.
She was in pain?
Yeah.
We should have called Geneva. You know, my friend Geneva got the original pain relief spray. You didn't take no spray last week?
I didn't take the spray last week, but this is an old school lady. We're not going to have a fight with her.
You should have. If you'd have got the spray, you could have sprayed her. She would have been fine.
I don't think I could have sprayed her where the pain was.
Oh, Lord.
But anyway, they rested today, so I got to
so they
go.
Good. Okay, well, we're going to be dismissing.
No, with them.
Okay, honey, can you get this? God be with you.
Every day, y'all.
God be with you. Come on, Sonny.
Oh, baby.
God be with you. Just at least hit the key. Until we meet. Can you meet me anywhere on the keyboard? Again. God. I'm going to come over here because, see, this is how I do. I'll be with you. He done turned it off. You know you ain't right. Excuse me. God. I can't hear nothing. Hold it. God.
with you. Have a happy Kwanzaa. Have a happy life. Make sure you take care of your family. Make sure you live right as best you can. Make sure you stay in the gospel, the truth, and love somebody. Love one another. And just be able to just be happy. Be happy. Be happy. 323-965-1611 is the office number here. You can always dial. Talk to me, Charmaine, Mr. Morris. We'll be of service to you. 323-965-1611 right here on RMCOnAir.com. You know, you can also check out our gospel on RMCGospel.com. We have several gospel shows. Pastor Culpepper, Pastor Warren J. Smith, Brother Prez Blackman, and A Mother's Cry, Evangelist Shirley Knight Harris. They are on RMCGospel.com. Soon, Pastor Kelsey Steele will be there. And so we are welcoming all of you who have a message and you want to be on our internet channel. Make sure you contact us. 323-965-1611. So, without any further ado, we want to thank you. Peace and blessings.
Good night.
Peace and blessings.
All right. All right. Good show, baby.